It's time for Florida State football. This is the Jimbo Fisher Show, presented by First Commerce Credit Union. The Jimbo Fisher Show is brought to you by First Commerce Credit Union. Now that's local strong. The Florida Lottery, over $28 billion in counting to education. Just imagine. The Florida Department of Transportation, drive sober or get pulled over. The energy-saving conservation programs of TECO People's Gas. Coke Zero. You don't know zero till you've tried it. SunTrust, the official bank of Florida State Athletics. Ram Trucks. More people are driving Ram trucks than ever before. Guts. Glory. Ram. Nick's Toggery, provider of Coach Fisher's wardrobe.
Hello and welcome to the Jimbo Fisher Show. Tom Block and Coach Fisher. And Coach, the news is good. Congratulations. A big, big win over Florida, and it caps a 10-2 season. Congratulations.
It really was. I'm very proud of our kids. I think our kids showed a lot of class and character down the stretch of the season and played very well going into a top 10 opponent on the road, your big rival. And they have a very good football team. We had a good football team, and our kids played extremely well on the road. And that's something we wanted to improve on, playing well on the road and doing it in all of the phases, and we did that.
You know, when you look back at this year, and there's obviously still a bowl game to go, and this is not unexpected because it was a young team, but to me you could really see this team grow as the season went on, and in my mind kind of progress from being afraid to lose to embracing how to win.
I agree with you. I think it took a couple of those losses to really get them to push past that, not fear of losing, but just the confidence is just to go play and quit worrying about things. And you know, you have to grow like that. And like I say, this team can be sitting, it's very close to being an undefeated team, but at the same time, it's not. And so, but to watch them grow and how they did things and the way they progressed, I'm extremely proud of this football team. I'm very proud.
A lot of highlights that we'll look at defensively. That was a tremendous effort. 27-2 in Gainesville.
That's the lowest out point for them in a long time. Again, somebody said most in ACC history going on the road against a top 10 opponent, fewest points ever given up. And it was actually given up on a missed assignment on the up front, on a miscommunication on a call. And our defense was outstanding. I mean, they played the pass, played the run, physical. I mean, just a tremendous football game.
A lot of highlights to get to, and we will do that as soon as we come back right here on the Jimbo Fisher Show. Welcome back to the Jimbo Fisher Show. Coach, this is always a big game, obviously, Florida FSU. I really don't need to say more than that. Tremendous atmosphere and a big opportunity for both teams with plenty at stake.
Oh, I mean, what an atmosphere. I mean, top 10, you know, top 12, whatever we all ranked, and, you know, up there for have big bowl implications. They still had a chance to be in the playoff, an outside chance. It's had a record-setting crowd at their stadium, over 90,000, I heard, I think it was. And just, I mean, that's what college football is about. That's why you come to Florida State. It's why you go to Florida, play in those games. Here we did. I tell you what, we did an outstanding job. We're talking about offense, defense, but our special teams, the way we kicked the ball, the way we covered, the way we did things, controlled that field position. Great job here. Guys just getting, batting balls, getting the hands and lanes to deflect balls. I mean, just so many different things. Good job up front. I mean, Sweat and Noddy and Niall Lawrence and DeMarcus Walker, you talk about played his tail off. And our linebackers right there, Terrence Smith, right there is Derwin James, I mean, just closing. What an outstanding game he played. Reggie Northrup, that whole crew of guys just outstanding up front. DeMarcus Christmas, young guy. And I tell you what, Bobo did a great job fielding punts. Did a nice job of creating the field position. We had a holding, and they got a late hit right there on two of them, so it was kind of offset. But now early, we had a couple missed assignments up front early. Just miscommunication on things, guys with nerves and silliness that I wish we could have started better. But, you know, we'll just keep working on it. The other good thing about tonight, he got hit here. We had a curl wide open. He got hit and deflected right there hit in the back. But no turnovers on offense, which is extremely critical in this game. Again, Derwin James covering on kicks. Man, this guy just does everything. He really does. It's a complete and loves to play ball. Right, and they pop a run here now. I mean, I told you, Taylor's a good back. Great job by Jalen minimizing it, getting him on the ground. And they found a crease inside. Taylor's a good player. Here they get a screen right there. Jalen back outside. There's Josh Sweat chasing inside that. Boy, is he going to continue to be a great player. Getting pressure, getting the hands up. Now, they had a guy there. We busted the coverage late. They couldn't get it to him. And got there. There's Terrence Smith. Great rush right there. Great up the middle on the sack, getting inside. Boy, it's great to have him back out there, man. So athletic. He's a good player for us. He was playing great before he got hurt and continues. Now we get a little naked. We get a little ball out in the flat to Dalvin. I'm going to tell you what they did. They tackle well in space. They got guys in the ball now. They got there, and they were. That was a physical football game up front right here. Sean, we got it, man. On the other shoulder, they squatted on the route. We ran right by him. We got to take it. We got to hit that thing. We left a couple opportunities on the field. A little nerves early, but our coverage was good here on the punts, and They won the field position battle a little bit early, and then we got it back. Great job, Reggie Northup, Derek Noddy inside, Terrence Smith, Nile. Those guys, boy, they played. Brutus, guys just all, they left it on the field. Big Giorgio in there, getting hands up on the ball. That's what I like, making contested throws. And there's Terrence, boy, making a tackle, being physical, finishing tackles. Good job up front, holding your gap. DeMarcus Christmas and the guys. You see Taylor, that's a heck of a run. There wasn't much in there, and he found space. Here, the now our guys are getting it back down, and sealing those holes back up. But, you know, just really good football. Here, they got a quarterback draw, and there's Josh Sweat coming off the edge right there. Josh being Josh. Boy, this guy's going to be glad we got him for a while more. Nice job right there. Nice tackle. You see Nate Andrews back out there playing, Javion Elliott, all the guys' defense. And they had a couple bad snaps, and that hurt them. And then some key moments. And that's what I say. You don't think about that shotgun snap. We had them early in the year. We had some problems with that, and it is a problem. Marcus Walker, good job. Guess he was posing for a picture. We don't need Dalvin to get the ball out in the flat. They tied their Neil, that safety boy. He's a physical player. Davis or backers. I mean, and we had a little trick play here, a little throwback to the tight end coming out the backside. Great job by Dalvin getting downfield. But I mean, there's Izzo made a couple nice catches in the game. Boy, he's going to be, as a freshman, going to be an outstanding young player. Here we hit the reverse. They didn't play. They played back on it, but we still got 4 or 5 yards out of it, which was good. That's what you need. Even slow them down. Hit a nice. I don't know what happened here. We missed a block right here. We had a couple drives in midfield, and we had a couple disappointing breakdowns. And right here, we got to get this ball up. We had a chance down the middle of the field. If we get that up, we get a first down. Sean was off just a little bit in the beginning, and we left some opportunities on the field. But he's learned to play on the road in big games. He's had 2 starts, Clemson and here, and that's about as big as it gets. Nile, great job in the backfield getting penetration on the guys right there. And we go to the second quarter, and I believe we're tied up right here. And then all of a sudden right here, we start to play a little bit defense. DeMarcus Walker had an outstanding game. Tackles for loss, sacks, he and Reggie Northup. Those guys, I mean, it meant a lot to them. Tyler Hunter, you see in the game, done a great job. Great job by Jalen right there on the sprint out, keeping guys in the pocket, making them, when he got out there, getting to him. Bobo, great job of going to catch the ball. Got hit as he's fielding the ball, got a penalty, which is very critical, and it was a great deal. Going to catch those punts. They let a couple hit the ground, and we didn't, and I think it was critical in the game. And we get a little drive right here, pop one, and this play is inches from coming all the way out. We're going to get that backside backer blocked, and that one there was Dalvin. We got a little flip play, got it outside. They wadded it up. They can run, too, now. And we got in the hole. We drive here. Ah, we got to make this. We got to throw and catch that slant right there. We get the first down and make the plays and do what we do. But again, Roberto was big on the night, hit two big time field goals, and now he's going to show why he's one of the best kickers in America. Big. He had to fight for every yard last night, getting it up, batting balls, unblocked guys in the back. Reggie batting that ball down. We had about 4 or 5 of those last night, which was critical. Rush, we're trying to rush the ball here. We're doing a great job up front. Did a good job on the run all night. Great job, Derwin James. Get him on the ground, Derwin. But there's Josh and Derwin. I'll tell you, that shows you how good Treon. Look what he just got out of right there. Now we get back to the ball. Getting away from those two guys. Treon's a heck of an athlete now. Here we are. We get the sweep right here, which is big. And now we're starting to loosen up, get a little momentum in the game right here. Four starts running the football. Nice play action by Sean right here. He hit a nice over route to Kermit. Kermit really makes a nice run right here on this guy. Boom. From behind, makes a guy miss. We're down there ready to score, and excellent job. Here we get a little play action. They cover it. Sean takes the shot, throws it away. Very smart play. They had it covered, just throw it away. No sense in it. Now here, 1-2. Sean comes back to his third read, finds Kermit. Boy, oh, boy. I mean, he was interested in getting in the end zone. I thought he was in. It's a shame. Now, I'm third down here. We got penetration off the backside. They shot a backer now. We got a block back on that, and they got penetration. Again, we went fourth down. We're going to come here to win the football game. What a play here by Sean and Jeremy Kerr. Finding each other, finding a hole. Throws it back inside. That is a big, big, big time throw and catch, and I mean extremely pivotal in this game for what we were trying to do here. We didn't want to leave it. Watch Kerr. See him settle down in the backside, find a hole. That's big time by Jeremy Kerr. Finding that window and that throw, that's incredible. It really is, and that's kind of the way those games are won. Here they get a guy over the top now, and a guy fell down on a corner route. They miss him. We're lucky. We can't fall down. Here we go, going back inside. Derwin, great job break on the ball, coming over the top to make a play. Making a play on the football. Again, another batted ball. Giorgio, that 6'7" frame, boy, getting in there and making plays. Defense was relentless all night long. Sean here, nice throw right there. Again, I believe, yeah, that's Izzo. A nice little route right there. And I think we missed a third down here. We get lucky. We got to flatten this thing out. Oh, no, this is the one we had. We had to throw it more outside. We had to see through it too far inside. We had a little hook. We knew on third down they would squat on routes. We wanted to take a shot on third down, and we had it, and dadgummit, just, you know, didn't get it executed. But, you know, wanted to play aggressive in the game. We were there to win it. We knew it was going to be hard to drive the ball, long drives on these guys, so we had to find ways to create big plays. Great job by the guys here. Again, pressure, sweat, and all the guys. Derwin, how about Derwin rushing? Derwin looked like a daggone defensive end. That was scary. Here we get a little boot naked. Found it. Nice job catching Bobo on the sideline right there. Now, we miss a block. I mean, how we turn this backside three technique loose? I mean, second and two, we just kept shooting ourselves in the foot. And then third down here, they play the route. I mean, we had second and one or two and didn't get the first down. That was disappointing. Now, they dump it down right there. Derwin, step on his toes, Derwin. You see how Taylor now? He's got some quicks. Guy's a good player. Getting batted ball. Underneath routes, shorter quarterbacks, you know, those are a factor. Good job. Making him move off the spot, though. That's a nice job. Now, go tackle. Good job, Marquez. Good job. Him and Davion right there. And Derwin forcing him out of the pocket. Nice job. They get a square, and they're moving the football right here. And they got it right before the half. Just a hair off. We almost got penetration on that. Kick it away. They missed a long field goal. And, you know, your kicking game, when you don't have kickers. But we go in there at half. We got the ball back, and coming out the second half up 10-0 and going the road, we'll take it.
Well, and you can see from the emotion there, it was pretty big from a momentum standpoint that Florida didn't get three going into the locker
room. You're exactly right. That can change. It's going right before the half. As you know, we do a lot of that ourselves, and that just changes the whole momentum. But just very proud of that we were able to hold them out of there. Charlie and the guys did a great job of managing the clock all the way down and got them to miss a field goal.
Big play of the first half, and there were several, but none bigger than that fourth down play, especially because short yardage situations have been tough this year,
exactly,
and that was
right.
A fourth and one there, and you went for it, played aggressive, and got six.
We knew we were going to go third and inches, fourth, and I said, I made my mind, we're going two downs to get it, and we see what happened on first down, so we went back to it on fourth down, run a play action, and that was, I mean, they had to play pretty well covered. We found a hole, and just players making plays, and great job by our guys.
Normally, you don't want to hear about a quarterback throwing kind of across his body.
Fourth down,
but that
ain't nothing wrong with it. It's fourth and one. What else you got to lose right there? This is crazy. And there was a hole. I mean, we teach when you're running on a naked, the guy that we're playing, you stop, settle back. Quarterback keeps running, you can find that hole. And we teach that's the way you got to settle in holes on nakeds and boots. And they did exactly what they were taught to do and then executed. That was critical. What a throw and catch.
Indeed. 10-0 Florida State at the half, but the second half gets even more exciting for Florida State fans, and we'll look at those second half highlights in a little bit. Stay with us here on the Jimbo Fisher Show.
Undefeated Season in Review is presented by Hyundai, proud supporter of college football and loyal fans everywhere.
Treon Harris, the inside play action for Roland Leck. Harris gets a pass. Harris intercepted by the goal. Picked off. Carlos in the 20-yard line. At the 30-yard line. Gets a block. Down the sideline outside of the numbers. It's all the way. Derek Smith will be hit at the gets a block inside the five. Touchdown, Florida State. The Seminoles take the ball away from the Gators. And Derek Smith returns it 95 yards. And the Noles get a defensive score. Bunker in motion. Play action by Treon. Here's going to be pass over the backfield. And one down for a loss. It was Chris Casher coming in and making that tackle. Switch off, and here's the snap. Delay pressure. Winston throws a pass. Near sideline. Boom. Rush iron. Touch. Coming at the 10. Jameis Winston completes his first long pass of the game, and he goes in on the regular shot green. So waits the snap, and here it is a good one. Pressure coming. Gets a pass toward the end zone. Caught ball. Touchdown, Nick O'Leary. Touchdown, Florida State. Put it in the hands of the guy with no gloves, and O'Leary slags it above the defender. It's a 10-yard touchdown pass, and the Noles lead for the first time today. This time, pass down the far sideline. It is intercepted at the 19-yard line, picked off by Brutus. LaMarcus Brutus, second pick thrown. Jameis Winston, the quarterback, hands the ball off. Dalvin Cook running left. Maybe lost his footing. He keeps going to the near side. He breaks the tackle to the 45. He's out of bounds at the 42-yard line. The 6-yard line. Play action fake, sold by Winston. Looks Winston close toward the end zone. Alley-oop. It's caught. Nick O'Leary three. Touchdown Florida State. He's got two today. And the Noles clicking on all cylinders. Now defense leads to offense. Another interception is turned into a seven-point trip by the offense, and it's 21-9. 38-yarder. The spot, the kick airborne, long enough, and it is good from the right side hash mark. Roberto Aguayo gives Florida State a five-point lead with a 38-yard field goal. They need a touchdown to win with 8 seconds left. Good snap, gets the kick away. Hurried it, tried to kick it away, and it's a line drive thing. Andre Dubose has the ball. He's going to come to the near side, runs up the field. He's tackled at the 31. No time left. Noles win. Noles beat the Gators again. Florida State 24, Florida 19.
Undefeated Season in Review is presented by Hyundai, proud supporter of college football and loyal fans everywhere.
Welcome back to the Jimbo Fisher Show. Coach, you get the ball coming out, and with a 10-zip lead, obviously the objective is to get this to be a three-score game and then go from there.
It was, and they got us on a three and out. We thought we could run the ball and had a couple plays coming out, and they got it. And then the second drive, we defense held, and we drove down and got at least three and still was made it two touchdowns. But that's the key. You're trying to get up to three scores and then stretch the game. Good thing we didn't have to work on kickoff return a lot. A little counter boot right here we had open early in the first half. They played it pretty well. Got to be careful. Try to throw that ball up and over, but they played the play. And we come out the back door right here. We missed the linebacker. If we don't miss that linebacker, we got a chance to make a play. Now, I'm going to tell you, Davis is a good linebacker. He hit Dalvin right there now. Third down right there. We had pressure. That's a green dog. We needed to bring the back on the other side and bring him across so they couldn't green dog. And unfortunately, that didn't work out too good. We actually got a grounding right there. But, again, now they get the ball, have decent field position. We're playing pretty well here. Defensive, though, he keeps setting those edges. There you go. That's DeMarcus Walker not letting the back get to the edge. Great job by him. We ask our guys to leave it on the field, and they did. There's Javion Elliott on the blitz coming off the backside, gets a sack. That's critical. He and Tyler Hunter, I mean, those guys are just, you see the excitement, the passion to play. And Dalvin, now we start to come. Now we start to get a little drive. Even though there's 3 and 4 yard runs, make it second and six, and you minimize the third down, we pick it up. We threw that ball a little bit too hard. We got to make that catch. That ball was like a rocket ball now. Third down. Now watch this thing. Knocks him back. He stays in bounds and then goes and gets that first and then gets hit again. Now, I'm going to tell you what now. That was as good a play as he had all night. And we hit a nice little, gets 5 or 6 yards. You see how physical they're tackling now. I mean, this is a physical football game. On third down, Sean finds a little double move inside to Travis Rudolph, and we're starting to pick it up, and guys are starting to, they're starting to be a little chippy. We need to be quiet. Now, third down, man, we end up a yard short. Dadgummit, on a flat route, and they played it. But then Roberto comes in. But a good drive. We moved the football, got some continuity. Catches the end of the inside of the pole. We're up 13-0. At least makes it a two-touchdown game. Here they're booting. Look at it. Keep leverage on the ball and had the tight end play. That's the way you play defense right there. Great job. Again, they manage it. They hit that score in 2 or 3 times in there on us inside. And they did a good job working the middle of the field. And they're starting to drive back right here. And get a little slant. They get a little momentum going and moving the football. And it's critical here. We don't want to get a score. If we do, it has to be a field goal because you don't want to give up, get back to a one-score game. Here they are. Now, again, Treon again with his legs. Makes some plays. And the guy's a good player now. He is an athletic player. In coverage. Have to throw it in the ground. No one's there. Trying to find lanes. Good job by our defense. Had pressure sacks and coverage sacks. Great job here, Terrence Smith, making a tackle right there. They pop a run. They get to a 4th and 1 here and just barely make it. Dadgummit. They barely make it right here. Great job by our defense. How he spun back in there now, I don't know how they got. I mean, got a good spot. But, hey, good run, good play, good hard run by them. That's ball. Again, we lost. Great job, Terrence Smith. I'm telling you, just seeing his speed and athleticism in there again, boy, it's nice to see it. Go to the 4th quarter. 13-0, just like we said. They go quarterback draw right here, taking it down in there. And we stop them right here. And then we hold right here on this 3rd down. This is where their pressure. Guys in the pocket, throw it away like we had earlier. You know what I mean? The coverage sack. And then they get it called, and that moves it back. And the field goal's not a – I was kind of pointing that out. And we get through and get a block. Man, just tremendous penetration. And that was critical. Because even when they get that safety later, I got it to a one-score game with a two-point conversion. But not giving up any points, right? Just momentum swings. Talking about, look at our guys getting up. I think that was DeMarcus, if I'm not mistaken, wasn't it? I mean, just the sheer ability to get to. Now we get a big run right here. We're going to go put the game away. We had a daggone holding call, which is extremely disappointing. Now we're getting a running game going here. We're getting some plays. But we come back. If we run it again, watch him make this guy. And that's a pretty good safety right there. And Dalvin, I mean, he's inches right here from going to the house with it. Just, I mean, shoelaces. I'm taking that thing about 80. And we get the momentum out of midfield. But we get stalled. We jump and have a penalty on first down. And we get a slant. And it says second and 10, first and 10. We had about 8 yards here. We had a second, our first and 15. Now we got 8 yards. And then we got it. They knocked the out route down. I mean, the outlet down. We get the third down and have to punt. Now, the good thing we did move it out there and change field position and pin them back. But, man, it was disappointing. It really was. But keep them pinned back inside the 10. They pop a run here. We first play were really good. That's Fred Jones, excellent play by him. Ricky Leonard in the game, those guys. See those young players, boy, just starting to emerge for us, Christmas. Now they pop a run right here, up inside. That was getting it out. Nice tackle by Brutus, because that kept it from being a touchdown. Now that's, they move the ball. Again here, great pressure off the edge. They couldn't get it up and down because of the pressure. That's a hard throw on them. Pressure here. Guys, find it. We stop them on third down. We come back, make a nice run here, get about 4 or 5. We're starting to get the running game going with a lot more consistency right here. A lot more consistency. See, Dalvin, boy, just gets it up. And then we just miss a block on the back. Daggone ball's got to come out of there. Third down here. And then this was caused by total miscommunication on the backside. One of them heard a run play, and it was a pass play, which we should have known. And, I mean, just got to grab a hold of that ball. Great job by Sean and Mavetti and those guys. You need to fall on that ball, Mavetti. I don't know if he just couldn't get a hold of it, but then Sean, it's a tremendous job of keeping that from being a touchdown. That is a critical, critical play. And then the other ones here, they get a penalty right here. They hit a big return on us. And they get a holding call right there, and they saw it, and very critical. It was a hold, no doubt. But because that would have been field position back, and they could have scored and got it to a one-score game. But the holding call got them back, and you can't make a mistake. We had some of those during the year. Almost an interception right there by the guys. And just in the end, don't lose a containment. Making that ball come out, just keep playing and playing on defense, boy. Just keep pounding. Terrence Smith, the guys on the blitz, I mean, nowhere to go. They just kept bringing the pressure. Derwin and the boys making plays. And we come back right here. Now we start to move the football. Nice route by Bobo. Got a one-on-one on the backside on the corner route and got it, which was huge. Now we come back with a counter right here. Now we're starting to pound it. There you go. Oh, Dalvin, stick that thing. I thought he was going to stick it up in there, but who's to question him? Great run. And now we pop this inside, and then we get the inside zone. Now we got the counter. Now we got the zone. Now we're just keeping a good mix of things and play action pass. And we got a good rhythm here in this drive. We pop another inside zone play. Safety overcuts it. Got to get on him. This guy gets in the end zone. It's a touchdown. And that was big. That gets it to a three-score game. That got it to a three-score game right there. That was really big. Really big. But they come right back with a drive here. This is where we fool around and let them score here about 5 minutes ago and get it back to two scores. You're crazy because they got timeouts and anything can happen. And they pop a run. We're a little bit of premium. Great tackle by Derwin. And they had some shots to the end zone. They get an interference call here on Javion and holding and has the play. But I'd rather give that up than a touchdown. Again, they go to a corner route, have a chance right there on the route and just overthrow it. They got him open. And we got lucky there, getting pressure again. When you hit the quarterback so many times during the night, though, all those things factor into that. People mm-hmm. don't understand. Well, he didn't get hit that time. Yeah, but he's been hit like right here, constantly running for his life on fourth down. Our guys getting out there making the plays. Giorgio Newberry and all the guys, Brutus, all those seniors, just remarkable. And, you know, now, this is what I'm proud of. We take the game over right here. Dalvin's smart enough to stay in bounds. We're running the clock. We're running that power play. We knew how they play it. Look at this, popping that power in and out. Got a face mask right there. I mean, just taking the air out of the ball, not letting them have it back. And then we're trying to just get a first down here, and unfortunately, this ball just popped out there, and he got a score out of it. But, didn't think. We're just trying to keep that first down. That was big, though, for him and just how we played and everything that went on. Just a great night for us, great night to be a Seminole. And those seniors break the senior record for most wins in a career with 49. And what a night for Florida State. Again, here we just tackle, get him on the ground, the last play of the game, and it's over with.
183 yards and a couple touchdowns for Dalvin.
You mentioned 49 wins. That senior class has a chance to get to 50 wins. Your special teams. I mean, just a lot of.
It was a complete team game. I mean, offensively, we didn't move, but we knew they were good on defense. We had our own self-inflicted just misassignments, some things that we got to get cleaned up, and just we know to clean up. Just keep the poise to go in there and do it. But then they still the toughness they played with to keep pounding. Defense didn't matter. Just keep pounding. Relentless effort. Special teams never let up. Never give them an inch to breathe anywhere. And that's what I was proud of.
Big play of the second half, and there were several. But that field goal block when they were getting down trying to score, man, that was a huge play.
It was. I mean, that we got them on the board, and then when that safety would have put them at 8 points away, a touchdown and a 2-point conversion. But just not allowing and the momentum swing it gave. Because, all right, we got all the way down there. We got stopped on third down. All right, let's get 3 points out of this. And all of a sudden, we block it. I mean, just every special teams, offense, defense, everybody was ready to play. And our coaches did a tremendous job of getting those guys ready.
All right, the bowl season comes next. We'll talk about the upcoming schedule and more about Florida State football when we continue right after this.
Hello, my name is Brock Ruble. I'm from Charlotte Hall, Maryland. This is my second year redshirt freshman, and I'm an offensive tackle. My very first football game, we got beat, and I was a tight end that game. I wasn't even an offensive lineman. I had two catches for like 7 yards, and I was a defensive end with a couple of tackles. Definitely nothing, FSU special going on in my first game. I didn't spend a lot of time playing football when I was younger. I was mostly a basketball player. That's what I thought I was going to do. I've been the same height since about eighth grade, ninth grade. So my body decided to, choose football, and I'm very glad it did. But football wasn't really in my mind when I was younger. It was more of a basketball, baseball thing. Baseball was one of my favorite sports growing up. That was the big sport around my way. A lot of Little League baseball, stuff like that. And then I actually helped out my high school playing, doing track and field for shot put and discus. Nothing special. They just needed someone to throw. So I went out there and I had a great time. Well, if you're not from my hometown, you probably can't find it. But just very quiet place, a lot of great people. It's a southern environment, even though it's up north, I'd say. Just, that's all I can say, great people, great environment. Well, one, how hot it was down here. I mean, never really been used to that. And also just how busy of a place Tallahassee can get. Like I said, I didn't really know too much about all that, so that was kind of a switch up for me. Also, like kind of the college town, like I've never been around so many, not only so many people, but so many people my age. So that was kind of a transition I had to get used to. Really just my two parents, everything that they did to help me put me in the position I'm in. They were two athletes that played in college ball, and they kind of helped me through that whole process and stuff like that. I would say that they had the biggest impact on my life, today those are my two heroes for sure. Completely like off season, the best thing I love to do is I like to go to the rec and play some basketball. One, to keep me in shape, and two, because that's still one of my favorite things to do. I really listen to everything. I think country is predominantly what I listen to. Blake Shelton be my favorite there. When I tend to relax and stuff, like R&B music, John Legend is probably one of my favorites. My high school was a very good team, but at the end of the day, coming to Florida State, the amount of speed that we have on the field, the athletes, I had to adjust to that. Not being, the best athlete on the field anymore is a big transition. That's when, the techniques that the coaches teach you and stuff like that, you really have to implement into your game or you won't be successful. It's hard, and but we all knew that. We all knew how what he expects and the bar that he has set. And obviously looking back, I mean, just recently, you know, the Trey Jackson, Cameron Irvin, I mean, the process works. And although it can get hard sometimes because he expects a lot, at the end of the day, we know that what he's doing is the best thing for us. Even though he's not older than me, or the same age, I look up to Rod Johnson a lot. You know, just the way he handled the great amount of success he had last year, how he's doing this year. And I would say that I got a lot better this year because of the way I kind of paid attention to what he did. And another one would be I really pay attention to Bobo. He sits next to me in the meeting room. And he said a couple things to me before, and they kind of stuck with me about trusting coaching and, you know, doing as they ask and how to approach practice and stuff like that. So those are the two people that, you know, when it comes to looking up to, they've had the biggest impact player-wise on my play now.
Come in about 6 o'clock every day. The morning is a lot of preparing for the day. So whether we're making protein shakes to kind of have meal replacements if the guys have lost their appetites, we put out vitamins to make sure that they get enough nutrition in their day. So if they're missing a meal or two or a serving of vegetables, it's a good safety net for them to have just in case something happens. How are you?
Good.
The morning also entails breakfast. So we kind of go in there, see how they're feeling. Are they able to eat today? Have they lost their appetite? Are they eating enough? Are they eating too much? So we kind of just touch base on that a little bit.
Hydration, right stuff.
As the guys are going to meetings, coming to special teams meetings or position group meetings, we try to really like, all right, who didn't eat enough breakfast? Who needs that extra fuel for that practice? And we kind of keep track of who's taking a snack or who's taking a hydration supplement. So we know the guys that are prone to heat exhaustion or they're prone to cramping. And that's the time that we really try to hone in and get that hydration supplement in them so that we prevent any cramping or heat exhaustion or heat illness prior to practice. Ready to go?
Nice
day. Okay, all the guys go outside and then we kind of prepare for practice.
Breaks are at 5 and 8.
I get my students in line, we kind of go over the breaks and they each have a duty at break. They each have a position group that they kind of manage and kind of watch. We kind of manage that hydration and that fueling to make sure that they're not dropping out based off lack of energy or lack of hydration.
Gummy.
So each student carries around water and some gummies or some quick carbohydrate snacks to make sure that they're not hungry or falling out.
Gummy art.
At least having that off your mind is, salt. You know, that's a blessing to have her and our staff, you know, working so hard and, you know, they care so much about, you know, us and our bodies and, you know, keeping us tip-top shape. You know, it's a significant part of the team. They always have sugary snacks. They give us, you know, these little nutritious gummy things that, you know, give us sugar and energy during the practice, and we get them during breaks. We have popsicles, you know, we get those during breaks. So, you know, her and our staff are great.
The first break is just kind of like a cool down hydration break, and we're making sure that, again, pushing fluids, pushing the gummies to make sure that they are fueled and hydrated. It's a quick turnaround break, just kind of gives the guys a breather. The second one is a longer break, about 5 minutes, and what we're doing there is helping reduce the internal core temperature through popsicles. With the athletic training, they give out cold towels, they give out Powerade and water.
Popsicle or gummy?
We're gonna go popsicles and gummies. So the popsicle is a cool treat, helps give their blood sugar a little boost, but also helps reduce their internal core temperature.
Paper. They help a ton. They're more eyes, they're more ears, they're more hands, certainly.
Okay, sit.
Definitely help decrease our heat illness problems.
Can you come help young Chris Miss with his cramp?
Full body cramping, things like that, when you just don't have enough guys getting the fluids that they need. Again, now more hands on deck, those things got better.
Chug that and then chug a whole bunch of water.
We carry around that hydration supplement again, that salt packet. We'll give it to the athletic trainers, let the athletic trainers assess the severity of the cramp, and then we'll kind of help push electrolytes and fluids there, and then kind of take a mental note. We'll come back at the end of practice, like, all right, who threw up, who cramped, So that next day, I can go back and be like, all right, here's what happened yesterday. Well, how can we prevent this from happening again? At close to the end of practice, our last period, we kind of go set up the tables. And our tables consist of all flavored, different flavors of Muscle Milk, flavors of chocolate milk. We do have a tart cherry juice that helps recover, repair, and control inflammation. We do other hydration mechanisms, whether it's coconut water or Powerade.
Pineapple mango.
On two-a-day, we did have a smoothie vendor from the community come in and bring smoothies, and that will help kind of give a special treat to, like, all right, maybe they're not going to take something because they're so tired.
Appreciate it.
But, oh, a smoothie's here, so I'll take a smoothie instead. Oh. An O-lineman could probably lose up to 8 or 9 pounds of water in one practice.
Mango.
We need to get mango. All of that and maybe then some back into their bodies.
Mango.
I could tell a big difference in the way we can practice. We can tempo practice a little bit better. And, you know, we can get a lot more out of the guys, I feel like. So, you know, I think she's a real big part of it, and I like the changes.
Welcome. We're just kind of making sure that everybody's status quo, comfortable, calm, and they're getting the nutrition that they need.
The Look Ahead is presented by Farm Bureau Insurance. Win a VIP experience at KnowlesContest.com.
Welcome back to the Jimbo Fisher Show. Coach, we won't know till Sunday in terms of the bowl destination and opponent, yep. but you already are formulating plans in terms of what the players need to take care of the next couple of weeks. Why don't you lay that out for us
well,
a little bit?
Well, hopefully we'll get some rest this week, but also maybe run a day or two just to keep our cardio and things in line. Maybe get a light lift on their own, but kind of let their bodies heal, let their minds heal, get away from things, concentrate on their academics, finishing up this semester strong, because the next week we have exams, and then we'll have to set a bowl practice schedule set coming up and have, you know, we'll probably be at the bowl game because it's going to be one of the most likely, hopefully, one of the playoff bowl game
in one of
the major, yeah, one of the New Year's Six, as they call it, and hopefully that's where we'll be and we should be. But we'll have to wait and see. But hopefully we'll be there a week. So we have a week of practice there, and we'll probably have to have, you know, eight or ten good practices right here before we leave and be ready to go and, you know, finish this season off with an exclamation point like we want to.
Yeah, no question. 10 wins already, a chance to get to 11, chance to get 50 wins for the senior class and win a bowl game as well. Some final thoughts coming up next on the Jimbo Fisher Show.
The Look Ahead is presented by Farm Bureau Insurance. Win a VIP experience at KnowlesContest.com.
Talking about the meniscus here on the Jimbo Fisher television show. We're here with head athletic trainer for football, Jake File. And Jake, we're talking about the meniscus. It's in the knee, but what exactly is a meniscus?
So there's two. There's a medial and a lateral, and basically they're cushions for the joint. There's one on each side of the knee, and they're kind of C-shaped, and they're kind of like a rubber ring that absorb impact.
What are the injuries associated with the meniscus?
Well, you tear them, and there can be different types of tears and severities of tears, different ways you fix them.
When we look at it, you know, I'm guessing there's different grades. How long? I mean, what are we looking at the difference in the sort of tears?
Well, they don't grow back when you tear them. So the only options when you have a tear is to remove the piece that's torn, or if it's a big enough tear, you can go in there and sew it back together and try to preserve it all. But an MRI is going to determine that. It's going to determine what type of tear it is, how bad it is. And again, if it's medial lateral, there can be some changes too, and maybe just the decision of what you're going to do to fix it. If you have a partial tear, it's kind of like having a hangnail on a fingernail, and it's going to bother you every time you plan on it or bend it. And they can, our team doctors can go in there or arthroscopically and just pull off that little piece. That can get better really fast. Our guys can return from that in 2 weeks sometimes. But if it's a bigger tear and there's a big piece of the meniscus that's pulled away from the rest of the body, maybe it's flipped into the joint, they'll go in and sew that back down where it's supposed to be, but that's a much longer recovery. That can involve being totally non-weight bearing and restricted range of motion for 6 weeks, and then another amount of 2 or 3 months of slow return to activity and rehab.
So really the difference between the two surgeries is just time of recovery. In the long term, which one have you seen to be more effective?
Well, they're both really effective. The benefit of the repair is long term for the player's career. And if you can do that, you want to do that. is, again, once you tear that piece out, it's not coming back. So if you can repair it and it works well, then they can, that's just better for their longevity, their career. Again, that cushion impact on their knee is going to last longer for their career.
Number one is going to be pain. Beyond that, what are some of the signs that it is the meniscus? Obviously, you're going to wait to get any x-rays or MRIs, but what are the signs you know this is a meniscus?
It's often, again, first off, pain is usually accompanied with swelling, but there's also can be a block in the range of motion. If a piece is torn and flipped into the way, you may not be able to fully bend or extend your knee. And if you can, it may be a hard pop through the range of motion, and it just feels something's not right, and it may be a little blocked.
We're talking meniscus here with Jake File. We'll see you guys next time.
Welcome back, Coach. As we wrap up the regular season, 10-2, it's been a lot of great accomplishments this year, and a tip of the cap to the fans, too, for their support throughout all the ups and downs in the season.
It really has. I mean, just thank them for coming and supporting us so well and making Dolt Campbell such a special place. We kept that undefeated streak alive. It's very tough to play there, and the fans are going on the road with us. I mean, this is, you know, it's all about players and all those young kids, but our fans are a big part of this, our alumni and our fan base, and the support they give us and what we have, and just very happy for them. And thank you for the season. Hope to see you all at the bowl game.
All righty. Sounds good. It's been another fun year. 10-2, not done yet. Have a great holiday season, everybody. We'll see you next time here on the Jimbo Fisher Show.
This has been the Jimbo Fisher Show, presented by First Commerce Credit Union. Brought to you by First Commerce Credit Union. Now that's local strong. The Florida Lottery, over $28 billion in counting to education. Just imagine. The Florida Department of Transportation, drive sober or get pulled over. The energy-saving conservation programs of Tico People's Gas. Coke Zero. You don't know zero till you've tried it. SunTrust, the official bank of Florida State Athletics. Nick's Toggery, provider of Coach Fisher's wardrobe.